Hello friends, in this video let's quickly talk about how to connect to the SQL server and how to read the data from SQL server by using Jupyter Notebook. Here I am going to show you practically one basic example by establishing a connection to the SQL server from a Jupyter Notebook. So here I will be using ODBC drivers to connect to the SQL server from Jupyter Notebook. So first of all, you need to see either ODBC drivers are installed or not. By default, it does not install on your machine. You need to specially install the ODBC drivers, then only it works. Then only Jupyter network connects to either SQL server or Oracle or any ODBC related stuff. Then how to install? It's very easy and straightforward. In the Jupyter Notebook installation video, I talked about pip. By using pip itself, we will install ODBC drivers in our machines. So let's go to the command prompt and let's run this command. So what is the command is? Pip install pyodbc, Python ODBC. So it does not take more than 30-50 seconds. It installs very quickly. So I just installed in my machine, you can see that. So I just ran pip install pyodbc. You can see the progress and it's quickly installed. The current version of pip is running in my machine is 19.0.3. I can upgrade, but still I am okay with that. So once it is done, then I can go to the Jupyter Notebook and I can connect to the either Oracle or SQL servers. So let's quickly start the Jupyter Notebook. Let's go to command prompt. And one thing, if you want this command, I'll keep this command in the description section. You can get that. Now let's quickly start the Jupyter Notebook. Hope you know that how to start Jupyter Notebook. Just go to the command prompt and enter Jupyter Notebook. If you have Anaconda on your machine, then nothing to worry. You can just directly go to Anaconda. There you can start. Yes, here my Jupyter Notebook is started. So in the previous video, I created one folder examples. Under that examples, I'll be doing my stuff. So let's create a new file. So in the extreme right side, you have a new option. Let's go click on that and click on Python 3. Here I will be working on Python 3 version. If you want to create folder and terminal, you can do that. But let's go to the Python 3. So once you click on Python 3, you'll get this window. By default, you'll get untitled here. Let's change the name. SQL operations. Whatever the name you want, you can keep it. Just to give a meaningful name, I just given that. Just to understand, whenever I come tomorrow, I can easily see that, oh, this file belongs to SQL. And this is the place where I'm going to write my programming. So it's very easy. It's very straightforward even. Okay. Now, so let's first of all import the namespace. Import pyodbc. Whatever the one which you installed, that you need to use it. Now you need to write a connection string here. So connection string, bit bigger one. See, if you see this, I just pasted here connection equal to, it's just a variable, connection equal to pyodbc dot connect. To which server you need to connect? Driver equal to SQL server native client 11.0. So I am planning to connect to SQL server. That is the reason why I provided driver as this and my server address. So this is my server. So in your case, if your server is your computer name, you can put the computer name. In my case, here I kept it as a dot. Dot is nothing but my computer only. So slash SQL 2016 and my database name is sample. So user ID is Venkat. Password is also Venkat. I have a SQL authentication user which I created for my examples. So this is the connection. So once the connection is established, then I can do that. Okay. So let's now you need to take one more variable. So I'm making as a name of the variable is cursor. Cursor equal to connection dot this is a connection. Whatever the variable you took earlier, you have to use connection dot cursor so that it opens a connection with cursor. Okay, so now, so once the connection is established, then you need to write a query. So how to execute the queries here? You can execute the stored procedures here. You can write a SQL direct queries here. So in this example, I simply write a SQL direct query. In the next example, I'll show you with the stored procedures. Now let's write down cursor, because I just created object cursor, cursor dot execute. Execute. So I'm writing a very simple query. Let me go to the SQL window and show you what query I'm writing. So I'll be writing this query only, select star from EMP. I already told sample database, name of the database is sample, and I'm just writing like this, select star from employee. So it contains this much of data. I have around 3 records with around 5 columns. This is a very basic table. So let's copy that query and put here in the quotes. So you can put it in the double quotes or single quotes, it doesn't matter. Yeah, I kept my code here. So here you can see this, this auto saved. The file it automatically saves. By any chance, if system down, it automatically saves. That is the advantage. Now, so here let's get the rows. So let's make it create one more variable with the name of rows or whatever the name you want. Rows equal to cursor. See here, this is a cursor dot. How many records you want at a time? You want all the records or all the records? You need to decide. I want all the records. So to that, you need to use one more function, fetch. Fetch all. It gives you all the records. So if you want only one record, fetch one. If you want all the records, fetch all. These are the system defined functions for ODBC. Now this rows contains all the records which are there in the MySQL table EMP. Then how to read that? How to read that is, so I can use here a loops concept, either while loop or for loop. It does not make any much difference to me. Let me use a for loop, because it's a rows is a collection, better to use a for loop. There's no difference in using while or for, but I feel comfortable in using for loop when I have a collection of rows, collection of values. So let's take it. So now collection for r, for let's row in rows. So rows is nothing but a collection. Row is nothing but a single row. You need to understand here. So I just defined a name like that. You can define whatever the name you want. It's up to us. Now let's put a colon here. Hope you know that why we are keeping colon. Now let's print this. Print of row. That's it. I'm done. So let's, once you are done, so you can save it. If you put a control S, it automatically saves. And here last checkpoint a few seconds ago, it means that it saved few seconds ago. So once you are ready with your program, so you can run it by using shift plus enter. Hope you know that. Let's enter it. Press shift and enter. See, once I do the shift and enter, I got the 3 records. Enter this one with a comma separation. You can see it matches my SQL server. Do you see this? This is a 200 first record. This is a 200 first record. Next one is 201, this C1. Next one 202, this one is this. It's a dummy data, just for my example I created it. Now, you want any specific column? That time you need to keep like row of, let us say I want only names. Make it as 1, because it starts with 0 index. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So when I specify index as 1 here, it gives you Chris, Raj and none. Let's run this. Let's again do the shift and enter. Yes. Now you see this, Chris, Raj and none. So if you want the other values, make it as 0, you get IDs. Let's run this, shift and enter. Yes, you got only IDs. You see this, 200, 201, 202. In the output, you have the same values. Now if you want some other values, make it as 3. Let's do the shift and enter. When you press shift and enter, it executes and it gives you the data. 3 is nothing but this. 0, 1, 2, 3. Now fourth one is all nulls. Let us see what four is giving. All nulls. Yeah. Shift and enter. Yes, all nulls. Yeah. So this is how we do connect to the SQL server and we do read the data from SQL Server by using Python. Not only SQL Server, in the similar way you connect it to the you can connect to any RDBMS. You can connect to Oracle, you can connect to any RDBMS in the similar way. So that's all about it in a basic example. In the next video, I'll talk about how to execute stored procedures by using Jupyter Notebook in Python code. So that's all about it. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions on Python, please comment your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. Also, follow me on Facebook for more technical updates. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe for more technical videos. Thank you.